Welcome back to AJ Kitchen Paper. I'm Asset, this is Oats. Meet Tofu Boys, let's do it. Let's go! Alrighty, ladies and gentlemen, start off by just taking your tofu out of the packaging for whatever reason. Then, in a strainer, let's get rid of any water in the shirataki. Alrighty, let's chop these boys in half, shall we? So grab them out of the strainer and just give them a couple of cuts. Runsky runsky. By the way, I don't know if these are actually related, but this is a different kind of shirataki that's actually found in Burma. Now that you've chopped up these lovely glassy noodly nudes, pop them back into the strainer for a little bit later on. Into a small measuring cup, measure out 100 milliliters each of sake, mirin, and soy sauce. And now to make sure that this is extremely sugary, add in 6 tablespoons of sugar. Now along with this absolute bombardment of sugar, add in 1 teaspoon of weba, or Chinese chicken stock. By the way, do not buy this tube of weba, it is gross. And give everybody a nice mixery mix together, and sauce and prep done. Excellente. Let's move over to the flame. So on a high heat, add in 1 tablespoon of cooking oil. Swirl them around to make sure it's nice and coated, and then 400 grams of very cheap beef cutoffs. Get everybody nice and browned off, lovely. Now that it's about 80% done, take it out of the pan and now add in your block of tofu. And just slide them in. Then magic in a second block, because why not? Whoops, forgot to film it. And while those are bubbling away underneath, add into your bowl of meat some of your sauce to let it marinate. Give them a quick tossity toss together. And let's turn our attention back to our browning tofu. We just want to keep flipping these and cooking these on a nice high heat until golden brown. Now you can buy pre-charred tofu in the packet, but this is a lot cheaper and a lot tastier. And this really only takes a few minutes, so there's no reason not to try and do this. Alrighty, Rooski, let's chop these boys up. Gracefully place them down on your chopping board. Now do your best to cut them into cubes while not absolutely trashing them. Gently does it, ladies and gentlemen, gently does it. And now that you've got these lovely little cubie boys, quickly pop them onto a plate, and then we're going to put them into an even smaller pan. Slide in all of your chopped boys into your pan. Again, be very careful not to break these up. What did I just say, Oats? Realize that maybe you put too much tofu in here and then take some out, because we still need to add our shirataki and our meat in here. So plop in a good handful of shirataki, and then pour in a good helping of our sauce. Probably don't need all of it. Now cover and leave it on a low heat, because we're going to simmer this for 15 minutes. Now take that lid off and let's see what's going on. Lovely. Notice that everything tastes a little funny because you bought the weird weba. Never mind, add in a bit of soy sauce and a bit of sugar to try and balance it out. And in goes your meaty boys. Make sure they're nice and snug and tucked in there. And then pop the lid back on because we're going to simmer for another 5 minutes. Now lastly, as a garnish, pop on some spring onions. Make sure you absolutely pack these on because pretty. And there you go, Dunsky Runsky. A beautiful pan of meat and tofu. Now let's quickly plate up a bowl for ourselves. So very carefully take out some of your tofu, a whole bunch of shirataki. Look at how much sauce the shirataki is taking on. And a good plop of meat as well. And of course, we need to take some of our garnish, so grab a bunch of your spring onions, along with a couple of hefty spoonfuls of our sauce. And there you go, she's all ready. With thumbnails out the way, tonight's drink is sparkling guarana water, because not everything needs to have an alcoholic drink along with it. There's also no sugar, which is always a good plus. Now that you've poured yourself out a glass, let's take a closer look at what we've made. Look at how absolutely dripping with sauce all of this is. Love it, taste test time. So there's 2 things to getting this dish absolutely perfect. That is one, don't buy the strange weba, get this one. And 2, make sure that you leave everything on a really low heat to get that sauce all the way through the meat and the tofu. This also makes sure that you don't overcook that meat. But if you just do those 2 things, you'll be absolutely fine. So if you're looking for a super quick, super easy and cheap meal to have after work, this is your go-to. So if you want to see more stuff like this, give us a like and subscribe. And let us know down in the comments below if you had a go. Alright, till next time, guys.